给你来，
从对主的感恩到对人的感恩都成为生活的一部分。
That let it be then, not only be thankful to God then, but to man as well then, and let this be a part of our lives.
今天的题目说人生配合。
Today then, I would like to share what is life.
有没有想过人生是配合？
Did you ever wonder then, or ask them, what is life?
每天如日出而作，日入而息，是配合。
So did you ever wonder then what is life every morning then you get up and night time you get to bed?
如果从世界的观念里面，他们给我们每一个人很多不同的解答。
And I'm sure that from the world's perspective then you will come all different answers.
但是今天我说我要从我们创造我们的神到为何创造我们的世上来回答这个问题。
But yet then today we will look from God's perspective then, the one that created us then, to answer this very question. So because he created me then, he created us then, so that's what matters most.
从圣经里面我们可以看到神给我们生活在世上有几个不同的目的。
From the biblical verses then, we can be able to get the answers then. What then were the different purposes that God created us?
一个活在主爱中。
The very first one that we are in God's love.
以生命影响生命。
Your life will actually influence other people's lives.
成为周围的人的祝福。
And become a blessing to others.
以神为乐。
And also be Let God then be your joy.
以神为荣耀。
And let God then be your glory.
我们今天也从耶利米先知看看他的一生是怎么过来看到一个榜样。
And from the very life of the prophet Jeremiah, then let that be our example.
今天是耶利米哀歌。
Today then, our scripture lesson is in the book of Lamentation.
我们知道那个时代是等于我们中国春秋年代齐国跟楚国争霸的年代，是中国历史上面很古代的。
It actually can be compared to the one of the history in China, a very certain period.
很久很久。
It's actually long time ago.
那个时候耶利米先知经历的就是国家内忧外患。
So not only there's internal problem then, as well as external problem that Jeremiah faced at that time.
而且他积极呢，就现在这个人在重伤他、逼迫他的当中。
And it's also in the time that they were being oppressed and persecuted.
那个时候真的是国之将亡了，国家将亡的时代。
And also the time then that the country then is about to be totally destroyed.
但是我们看到今天的经文，耶利米先知竟然可以说这几句话。
But yet, then, in times like that time, then, and yet Jeremiah, prophet, was able to say these words.
就是刚才我们读的，我想起这事，心里就有指望。我们不知消灭是出于耶和华诸般的慈爱，是因他的怜悯不计断绝。每早晨，这都是新的。你的诚实记性广大，我心里说，耶和华是我的份，我要仰望他。
To the point he was able to say, yet this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion.Therefore, I will wait for him.
耶利米先知纵观他的一生，我们看到他做了四个事情。他的生命的重点是四个重点。
So from his very life, then, there are four important factors.
第一个，他经历了神的爱。
The very first one, he experienced God's great love.
从二十二节，我们看得很清楚，国都差不多亡了，乱七八糟了。他还说这是神的慈爱，我们还没有被消灭。
In that time, then the country was about to totally be destroyed, and yet he was able to say, God's great love are not consumed.
这是在二十二节里面看到的。
It's from verse 22. So to the point, because he experienced God's great love, that's why he was able to boldly say he was hopeful.
24节他又说我要仰望他。
And to the point he would say, I will wait on the Lord.
在24节的仰望跟21节的指望都是同一个词，就是人生有希望。
Being hopeful then and wait on the Lord then in its original text, they meant the same thing.
这个是他第一个做的事。第二个，他的生命重点就是他听话爱家人。听话什么？听话。Okay,
so that's the very first factor. He waits. He's hopeful, and secondly, he listened to God's word.
他爱他的家。
He loved his family.
因为从耶利米书里面看到他多么爱他家里的人。
Because from the book of Jeremiah, we will be able to realize how he greatly loved his family.
第三个他做的事情就是他也是听话，就是听神的话，他爱周围的人。
And not only he loved his family, he loved God, and most of all, he also loved the people surrounding him.
因为在那个时候的教导就是说，从利未记19章不同的经文都看到神说，无论是敌人也好啊，你外国人也好，住在你们那里，你们都要爱人如己。
Because in Lamentation, the same way that the book of Leviticus, he said that not only to love his own people, even love those pagans and love those foreigners, the way you love others, the way you love yourself.
第四个耶利米37的生命重点也是听话，他爱国，爱万国，爱万民。
And the fourth one, not only that it was able to expand to the point that he loved his own country as well as other nations.
为什么？因为他知道神吩咐他，从耶利米书1章5节，神吩咐他说：“你没有出母胎，我已经派你做列国的先知了。”
Because right in the Old Testament, he said, because while you're in mother's womb, I already destined you to be the prophet of all nations.
而且当时的教导，神的教导，就是比如说从历代至上啊，到诗篇，常常我们都听到他们说，我们要在万民中传扬神的作为。
And not only in 1 Chronicles as well as in the book of Psalms, that it always tells us then that we.
什么？万国的什么？啊，万民中传扬神的作为。
Oh, right in others then as well as in all nations that try to spread and talk about the salvation of God.
也传扬神的救恩啊，就是。
Proclaim the salvation of God.
所以耶利米全都做了。
But in all these, and he abided, he obeyed, and he did it.
因为他活在神的爱中，他做了。Because
he's living right in God's love, that's why he was able to accomplish this.
致使他经历饱经忧患。Even
to the point that he came across, experienced all sorts of hardships in life.
他都可以舍胜取义的活得精彩。
But yet, and he was able to live a full of excitement and be able to live a righteous life.
我们期盼从耶利米先知的生命当中，这股郁金。So
let us learn from Jeremiah then, from his past experiences.
让我们可以心体力行。
That to the point then that we will able to learn and it's you know emulate them and live out that kind of life.
所以我们要做什么？今天我们做什么？我们还没有打仗，还没有国家将亡啊。
And how about us today? That we did not even go to fight them in a war then. And to the point then we didn't experience what he had experienced.
第一个我们 要的就是说，在我们生命要的就是说，我们要知道神怎么的爱我们。
The very first thing we have to bear in mind is the great love of God, how He loves us dearly.
今天早上主日学，我们就是讲到神怎么的爱我们。
In the Sunday school this morning, then we shared about the love of God.
我们也提到说这个世界不用好像现在这样子乱七八糟的。
And today, even though we're living in a chaotic society, then in a corrupt society,
本来世界不是这样子的。
But initially, at the very first, initially, God's plan, it's not like that.
神创造这个天地给我们来跟他一同享受的。
And God created this heaven and earth for us to enjoy.
跟着他来做，生了来做就可以享受永远跟他在一起的。
If we follow, if we would have followed Him, His words, then we will be able to enjoy that His companionship.
但是从我们上主开始就没有跟了，所以一没有跟，远离了神的吩咐，这个字就叫做罪了。
So, but then our forefathers have sinned, fallen short of what God asked for them. That's why we, the same way, we have this sinful nature.
Yeah, 有了这个有罪，这个字只是说远离了神，不是用来批评人，说你不乖不好什么是不是的，只是一个很客观说远离了神了。
The very essence of sin then is we already departed from God.
远离了神，神说有后果。As
we all know, then there would be outcomes, the end result then of staying away from God.
有后果，其中最大的后果就是我们本来可以跟神永恒的在一起，但是现在要死掉。That
is all then. Initially, we can eternally enjoy with God then, but because of that sin then, we need to face death.
所以神非常痛恨罪恶，因为这个罪恶将人跟他分开了，这不是他的本意来的。
So that's why God hates sin then, because then this is not what He planned for, to the point that we are eternally departed from God.
他心很痛，但是他说看到孩子们受这么多，这是罪的后果，苦得不得了。
And to the point He saw them, the very outcome, the result of why of our sin then, so He was suffering instead, and He was painful also.
他说：“没有人能够救他们，唯有我可以派我的儿子来代替他们死，代替他们受罪赎罪，他们才有机会可以再跟我在一起。”No
one will be able to resolve this issue of sin then, except He Himself by sending His only Son then to take away the sin.
如果你看到周报当中，今天我也带来了一些经文送给大家的，我们就看到圣经里面已经很清楚告诉我们。 神派他的儿子来为我们，是在这个当中你们有吗？在你们的周报里面，我们经常会读很多圣经，因为圣经就是神给我们的力量。
There's insert then right in your bulletin then, and this is actually the very summary then of what I will be sharing, because there are so many verses and biblical verses are indeed the very words of God.
圣经里面说，约翰福音3章16节，我们一同来念这个圣经。
Let us read the very last verse here, John 3:16.
你们可以用中文，可以用英文，什么语言都可以，因为神都听得懂。Because
you can read it in Chinese then or English.
我们从来念。神爱世人，甚至降他的独生子，赐给他们，叫一切信他的，不至灭亡，反得永生。For
God so loved the world that He gave us His only begotten Son. That whosoever believes in Him will not be perished, but have eternal life.
中文、英文都有登出来，好，我们可以一同用不同的语言来念。那这个就是代表了神对我们的爱，而且在圣经里面，约翰一书第四章第八节，他告诉我们，这个神就是爱。And
also in the book of 1 John, then it clearly written that recorded for us to read that God is love.
就是因为他是爱，他是源源不断的可以给我们。And
because He's the source of love, then He's always forgiving love to us.
2000年前他怎么来到这个世界爱我们，2000年以后都是一样的。Over
2000 years ago, He came to this world loving people. Then the same way today, He's giving His love to people.
但我们好像耶利米牧师一样，活在神的爱的当中之后，学习他的榜样来爱人的时候，我们就能够爱其他人。And
if we have this kind of love then, and learn from Prophet Jeremiah, then be able to love the people surrounding us.
因为耶稣是我们的榜样。
Because Jesus himself did, set himself a model for us.
而且在约翰一书，这里打错了，这是第二个。约翰一书4:9，我们一同来念，中英文一同来念。我们爱，因为神先爱我。
We love because he first loved us.
因着他做我们榜样，他浇灌在我们当中，所以我们能够同一样的将这种爱发放出来。Because
he loves us, he filled us with his love. That's why we're able to share the love of God to others.
凭借三个圣经，其实整本圣经都是告诉我们神怎么爱我们。凭借三个圣经，我们在脑袋上面、头脑上面，是不是已经知道神很爱我们？So
as we all know, entire Bible then talk about God's love then, and based on these three biblical verses then, are we able to fill our mind then, clearly know then that our God is love?
当我们知道以后。 第二个一定要有的事情，就是我们要经历过神这种爱，我们才人才会相信上帝真的。And
not only we know it in our mind, we have to experience God's love to be able to do so.
举个例子，怎么去经历神爱？神在圣经讲过什么？竟然在我生命当中发生，或者在我周围的人当中发生。How
are you going to experience it? Not only in your knowledge, you have to experience in your life and. Based on what biblical verses have told us.
举例来说，现在如果我经历到真的是头崩压裂，真的是好像是人到尽头的时候。
Just like in your personal life, then you have to the point that you felt so helpless and no way out.
但是我想起圣经告诉我，神要我们承受不会多过我们能够承受的，到受不了的时候，他一定会开一个出路。
And you will bear in mind that what God promised us then, even to the point then, that we're able, at the end of our reach then, that we're not able to do so, but God will open way for us.
然后你说，哎，我现在还是觉得还没有看到这个路，这个就是希望了，因为神答应嘛。But
even if you say there's no way out, then I'm totally helpless, no control over. But you're hopeful then because you're grabbed on the very promise of God.
又或者说，记得圣经说，骄傲在败坏之前，狂信在跌倒之前，神不喜欢骄傲。As
we all know also, the Bible says that before any destruction comes in, it's because of your boastfulness. That's why we need to humble ourselves before the Lord.
那我突然发觉，哎呀，我。 我这趟失败，因为原来我是骄傲，我就感谢神，原来已经提醒了我。It
turned out the biblical verse comes to your mind, then you know that you failed because of your boastfulness. Now it's the time for you to come before the Lord because of His promise.
又或者是我每一次来，我都一定祷告的。这里的确很难，神你为我预备。
Just like as you come to the church, then you probably have a hard time looking for a parking spot. But you pray there and ask the Lord to prepare a parking spot for you.
我不是好像我以前拜偶像说，神你给我，我就当你是好神。
And we will no longer be like in the past. And how oftentimes we say, ask God, and if God grant what I ask for, then I will come and worship you.
而是我在脑袋正想到一个圣经说。 神说：“我开始了的圣工，我一定会完成，所以我相信他一定给我好好的安排，我可以来到这里。” But
yet, then comes to your mind that God's word, whatever He started the work, He will definitely finish it.
是印着这个圣经。上次我来时候是夏天，他给我在有一个树挡住太阳的上面拍摄。
It's just like last time when I came to share with you that it's so hot in summer that God prepared a spot for me right underneath the tree
there.今天是冬天，我说神，我走不了这么远了，很冷。对面就是我的车。But
yet today is, as we all know, now it's winter then, but God prepared a spot for me right across the street from the church.
神就是这种神，他答应过，他一定会发生。
This is our God, and when He promised them, He will personally fulfill it.
当我感受到神这么爱之后，神这里会说：“怎么才可以？我是耶利米先知。”第二个事情，我要做的听神的话，神说：“你要爱我啊！我这么爱你，你就爱我就可以了。” So
the second thing, then, since He's loved them, then He also asks us then to love Him in return.
那怎么爱法善的层面?
How are we going to love him?
我们第一个层面是在单章的中间的第一个生命记六章四到九节。生命记六章四到九节。
The very first one is in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verses 4 to 9.
我们一同用中英文一同来读哈。以色列啊，你要听，耶和华我们神是独一的主，你要尽心尽性尽力爱耶和华你的神。我亲日所吩咐你的话都要记在心上，也要殷勤教训你的儿女。 无论你坐在家里，行在路上，躺下起来，都要谈论他。我都要记在心上，带在额上为经文，又要写在你房门的门框上，并你的城门上。神说第一件事情，你爱我，你怎么爱我？你现在爱我，然后你教导你的孩子们。
So here it says, God said, you love me, then at the same time you have to teach your children, impress them on your children to love God.
这个是每一个人的护照.
This is actually the very calling for everyone.
无论你现在多大多小,都是我们的护照.
Whether you're young or old, and no matter what age you are then, this is everyone's calling.
然后我们不单只是言教,还要
So it's not only teaching them in our tongue then, we should also teach our children with our own actions.
我们要先做好神的门徒像耶稣。
So we ourselves then have to be good disciples of God.
然后我们才可以教导我们的孩子成为基督的门徒。
It's only in doing so that we'll be able to teach our children to become children or disciples of God.
有人说, 那牧师你是不是代表说我们不需要儿童主日学?
So you probably ask the pastor that there's no need for a children's Sunday school?
当然不是。
Of course it doesn't mean so.
因为我们在家里教以后带到主日学听老师教的时候孩子就得到一个确认说哦真的父母教的老师是这样子教。
It turned out bringing your children to the Sunday school then, by doing so then, whatever the teachings from the Sunday school teachers then, will coincide then, with the very teaching of the parents.
让孩子觉得,哦,是一个reaffirmation, 就是确定了他所学的。
This is actually a confirmation then of the very teaching from their parents.
还有要记得,现在很多年代,不同年龄层的人,他们父母都没有信主,那谁来教啊?
So we have also to bear in mind in today's time that there are so many parents themselves that they are not Christian. So who then are going to teach their children?
那我们已经信主,不管什么年龄,都可以帮忙这些老师来辅助这些
So we ourselves should be able to fill up this very gap then of teaching those children.
还有为什么要教？因为我们外头世界实在是太黑暗了。
And why we also to teach the youngsters of today then? Because as we all know, it's actually indeed then it's very dark out there.
我们需要在孩子接触到外头的外影响之前，建立好他们美好的属灵的自肉啊。
Before they are influenced then by outside factors, by the society, we need to build that kind of foundation right in their hearts.
因为最好就是在年轻人进学校以前就要知道。
Far more than, it's better than, before they even enter school then, to build that kind of foundation.
如果你说迟了一点,最好在学校派给他们每一个人小电脑以前就已经知道。
And also before then, they're given that kind of computer then, in school then, we have to put them right in those children's hearts.
当他们在学校外在外头环境，看到一些神所不喜悦的事情时候，他们就知道这个不能做，因为有外后果，这个是罪，有外后果。
So far more important than before they were influenced by others and or by other people teaching them. They already have in their mind and have the right discernment. What should they do or what should they not do?
这个就是要教导的重要的原因。
And this is also the very important reason why we have to teach the youngsters.
我们在教导时不是说你做什么来去让他们挤向神。
What we're trying to teach them and put them, let them keep in mind is they have always have to focus and put their attention in God.
你跟着神来做，你不犯罪，你受着很多苦啊。
Because telling them that if they don't follow God, then they will come up, they will bear the consequences of their own actions.
第二个爱神的层面就是说要爱人如己，就是在这个马太福音22章37到40节。
And the second stage then of loving God then is loving others the same way we love ourselves.
啊，我们一同来念，也是所有语言一同来念啊。 耶稣对他说：“你要尽心、尽性、尽力爱主你的神，这是诫命中的第一，也是最大的。此旨也上好，就是要爱人如己。这两条诫命是律法和先知一切道理的总纲。”我们想象这个图画，神说：“第一个，你爱我，你先从你自己开始，从你家里开始爱你的孩子。” 当你习惯了这个，也看到美好的果效的时候，受苦小了很多的时候，或者面对困难都不怕的时候，你就很自动想起周围的人。Try
to imagine this picture then. First, you love God and be able to teach your children, and to the point that this will come very in a very natural process that you'll be able to love others.
因为什么？ 不单指他们会好，他们如果人周围人想犯罪，我们要。
As we all know that probably you said this is a lesser sin that it will be much lesser of a punishment.
因为很多时候其他人远离神，受害人不单只是他们自己，还有他们周围的人。
Because how oftentimes if a person wander away from God, then the one that suffers is not only the person himself, but also the people surrounding that person.
所以很自然的，我们越来越像耶稣，有这份的恩典，真的嘴巴闭不住，告诉人家有另外一条路可以走。And
if we have already experienced all this wonderful grace from God, then it's very natural then that we're not able to be tongue-tied, but can't wait then to the point of sharing the wonderful love of God to others.
当我们爱人如己的时候，很多时候我们想到说，哦，人家没有衣服穿给他衣服，没有饭吃给他饭。And
when we get to the second stage of loving others, the way we love ourselves, it comes natural then for us to lend or help, give a helping hand to those who are hungry and those who are without clothes.
但是我们在这个的做这个时候，我们永远记住，我们活在主的爱中。我们会告诉人，我做这个不是因为我有多棒，乃是因为我的神这样子爱我，我就这样子来爱你。As
we're able to love others the same way we love ourselves, then we will be able to proclaim or say to others that I did this. It's not because how great or how better am I then. Than you did, but I'm doing this all because of I have experienced God's love. And this is the greatest blessing that we are able to share to others.
换句话来说，我们做任何事情都是为神而做，为了传福音。
In other words, in whatever things we do, then we do it in the name of God, and all for the purpose of sharing the gospel.
然后第三个神说，你都这样子爱我，第三个我请你们做的啊，就是马太福音28章18到20节，就是爱万国万民。So
thirdly, then, if we're able to love others, then we're able to expand in a broader sense then, to love other nations.
我们一同来读这段经文，就是大使命的经文。So
this is the Great Commission then. Let us read together Matthew 28:18-20.
耶稣近前来对他说。 天上地下所有的权柄都赐给我了，所以你们要去，指望您做我们的奴仆，奉父子圣灵的名给他们施洗。凡我所吩咐你们的，都叫他们遵守。我就常与你们同在，直到世界的末了。再想下这幅画，你懂自己。 从家人、你的下一代、周围人，你都爱习惯了。当你碰到其他人的时候，无论你在哪里，你都应该不能停止，让人家知道神。
The same is true then. Picture this then. You love yourself. You teach to your children. You love the people surrounding you then, and or neighbor then, and in the expanded then, you're able to love those people that you come across.
也很留意这段经文啊，神叫我们说，你们要去啊，喜欢民众我的门徒啊。And
keep in mind here it says, go, let other people become my disciples.
这个去不用去到很远的，当然我们有支持的宣教士去到很远，我们这个去可能去门口，或去超市场，去开车转悠，都是去啊。
Go. It doesn't mean necessarily mean you have to go to a far place. And who knows that it could be probably right outside your doorstep or right in the supermarket as you go.
去干嘛啊？喜欢你做神的门徒啊。
You go then to let other people then become my disciples.
如果你已经习惯在家里面每一天都是这样子叫你的孩子，你的周围人、你的同事都这样子不知不觉影响到。
So if you come and do it naturally right in your home, in your neighborhood, in your community, this will become a normal and natural process then to go and share the gospel.
我们分享信息,然后就什么,教训他们遵守。
Not only sharing the gospel then, but ask them to obey.
那神真的很有智慧。
Our God is full of wisdom.
他说：“你只要用心的传这个福音，叫他们遵守。”
You just all we have to do is share the gospel and ask them to obey.
你爱我就只要做这个。
If you truly love me, you just have to do this.
如果对方不听话，我不算你的账。
If other people don't want to listen, then don't try to take it to heart.
因为他们听不听是他们跟神的关系，我们尽心。
Because the other parties, whether they listen or obey or not, then it's God's work. Then we just have to do our part.
尽力的去做.
Just take it into full our duty then to go and share.
靠神的能力去做.
And with God's strength, then we boldly go and do it.
不是应着我们的义务，或者是我们叫做基督徒，所以要去做。
Not because then I, this is my duty, then I want to do it.
乃是好像只三章圣经有两段，就是圣神说你先爱我，然后你去做。
But yet then it's all because of three passages then that we love God. That's why we want to do it.
当有一个人爱你爱到一个地步的话，他不跟你讲什么，你都想做讨他喜悦的事情啊。When
a person truly loves you, then before you even say anything, then you will gladly do the things to please him or her.
如果你爱我们自己的家的话，没有人叫你倒垃圾，你都会自动的拿出去啊。If
you love your family, you will tend. It comes natural then to go and throw the garbage without people telling you.
所以，当我们爱主的时候，不是因为神要我们做什么事情来爱他，乃是因着爱，然后我们就会这些事情发生。The
same is true that we experience God. God is love then, so it comes natural for us to pay back because of our love to Him. We will gladly do it.
然后我们整天讲爱爱爱，有没有想过神定义爱他是什么意思？
I wonder, we often talk about love, love, love then. And what is destined for us to love?
我们怎么叫做爱主啊?
What do you mean truly then by saying I love God?
如果我们从电视、电脑、什么报纸找这个爱主的意思的话，他们也会给你很多答案。And
I'm sure then from the computer, from the written articles, that we will come with all sorts of definitions of love.
但是呢, 你会发觉, 他们是讲感觉，爱是一个感觉。
But yet then, what they talk about love is simply their emotions, their affections.
我感觉应该爱你，我就爱你了。我感觉不好，所以我就不爱你了。
I feel good, so I want to love you. But if I don't feel good in a bad mood, then I no longer love you.
这个不是神的爱。
This is not God's love.
我们今天早上主日学时候读到说，神在我们还是这罪人的时候，都为我们而死。我们都还没有觉得他爱，就已经爱我们。但总之就是爱。This
morning in Sunday school, we talk about while we were yet sinners, God loved us. In other words, when we are not even worthy of His love, He already loved us.
我们看看圣经怎么定义爱主，就是在。 第三面的三个圣经都是在约翰福音跟约翰福音十四上。So
what it means by loving God and what it means destined to love God.
很简单，我们三个经文一连续的读下去，中英文一同来读哈。我们读：你们若爱我，就必遵守我的命令。我若不爱你，又遵守的，这人就是爱我的。耶稣回答说。 人若爱我，就必遵守我的命。我的道理。那很简单，爱就是什么？
Simple. What is loving God?
遵守他。
Meaning keeping His command.
遵守他的命令。Obey,
keep His commands.
神爱我，我自动就会遵守他的命令。
God loves me, and I love Him. It comes natural that I will obey His command.
但我遵守命令时候，神眼光就我就是爱他。
So when I keep His command, then God love them will always dwell in me.
然后我遵守神的命令的时候，就是代表我没有掉到罪这个层面当中。And
if I love God, obey His command, I will hardly fall into sin.
我不但使我自己受着很多苦。Not
only then, I will avoid so many bitterness.
周围的人也不会因着我犯罪与受苦。And
the people surrounding me then will hardly then suffer then because of my sin.
然后神的名又得到荣耀。
And at the same time, God's name will be glorified.
然后每个人都快乐。
And everyone will be in a joyful spirit.
看到神的智慧吗？
Do you know that? Have you seen that the wisdom of God?
当我们完完全全因着爱神来遵守的时候。
And if we truly love God and able to obey His commands,
不是因为我们的职任要做，也不是想神从神拿到什么这样子的功利主义来做的话。
It's not because that out of duty or responsibility we want to do it or want to get some blessings from God.
我们就可以活得精彩。
Then our life then will be full of excitement and glory.
那这个很简单哦，很简单。 我没有说很容易，我说很简单。
I didn't say it's easy, but I said it's simple.
我们怎么才可以知道遵守啊？
How can we know then that we obey God?
我们一定要知道他说过什么啊？
Of course, we need to know then what He's teaching.
所以你会听到每一个传道人、每一个传福音的人说，你信主以后第一件事，每天读经、读受祷告啊，因为什么？你要知道他说什么，他喜欢什么。
So as we all know, many servants of God, the very first teaching then after we become a believer then is to pray and read His word.
那我看到我进来的时候，看到你们有灵兽的材料，很好，灵兽材料的灵命日粮。
And when I enter your church, then I've seen so many daily bread then in English and Chinese.
非常好，材料我一直在用了二十几年，我用的是英文本，你用中文本，它什么语言都有，每天读一点圣经，融化在生命当中，应用在生命当中，跟神祷告。
You have it in English and Chinese, and I myself have been using for over 20 years then. Every day, read the word of God, let it become part of our life then, and be able to live it out.
然后他还有一个一年读经计划，你明白不明白？总之就读。And
also they have a plan in there that read through the Bible once a year that whether you understand it or not, just read by the Bible.
因为你信了主以后，圣灵会在你的心中帮助你明白。Because
we believe in God and the Holy Spirit will help us to understand.
然后你找到一个神叫你为你预备的神的家来继续。 敬拜神，也一边学习。
And at the same time, God had prepared for you a church there that we will continue to worship God and continue to grow in God.
这样子你的生活自动的就会跟神联想关系，圣经不是跟我们有距离的，不是一本书。
It also comes natural then that our spiritual will grow then and the God's word then will not be away from us.
那我们如果是每天这样子 OK 大家一个挑战哈，今年开始你们每个拿一个教会已经有的了，看到没人一同来这样子读，大家共同话题是很有趣的。
And I would like to challenge everyone and try to go and grab a book then whether in English and Chinese then it will be of help then to your spiritual life.
还有更重要就是说我们是用祷告跟敬拜神的心来读。
And also use a worship of spirit then, and prayer then to read God's words.
因为我们不是想从神拿到什么，乃是要期盼神得到我们的心。
Because we're not hoping to get something from God then, but praying that God will take hold of our heart.
如果你们一直读的话, 很容易看到神喜欢什么，神不喜欢什么。
And if we read God's word, then all the more we will come to understand it and know what pleases God and what you know that God despises.
我们尝试用很快的时间读两段经文。第一段就是在这个第四面的，第一段就是神所喜悦的，是爱的宣言；第二段就是在箴言，应该是6章16到19节，神最不喜悦。我们读一读这个，看看神对我们说什么。
So from here, we're able to know that. Let us try to read it and try to keep in mind it, what God loves to, you know, us to do and what God hates.
第一段哥林多前书13章4到8节，爱是很久忍耐，又有恩慈，爱是不嫉妒，爱是不自夸，不张狂，不做害羞的事，不求自己的益处。 不轻易发怒，不计算人的恶，不喜欢不义，只喜欢真理，凡事包容，凡事善信，凡事盼望，凡事忍耐，爱是永不止息。神所恨的箴言书第6章16到19节，搞错了。箴言书6章16到19节，耶和华所恨的有6样。 连他亲所憎恶的共有7样，就是高傲的脸、撒谎的舌、有无人学的手、图谋二计的心、飞袍行恶的脚、突发言的脚阵阵，并弟兄不善纷争的人。如果神说你爱我，你就遵守。第一个反应会是什么？If
you love God, then you would like to please him, and what is would then be your first reaction?
我通常听到说很难呢。I often
hear people say, "Well, it's hard."
我一直说很简单。But yet I
often kept saying it's simple.
没有说过很容易。I
didn't say it's easy.
当我感觉很难的时候，我第一件事会做什么？If
I feel then, if I think then, it's hard then. What would be the first thing that I would do?
我第一件事情就是说，神你吩咐我做的，你一定会让我做得到。不然的话，你就是说谎话。不然的话，你怎么拿我来开玩笑？因为你是爱我，我第一个想到这。My
first reaction then was saying that Lord, you know that you will grant me the strength to do so. Otherwise, you will be lying.
还有，我会想到神多少次在圣经里面说，这我没有难成的事。
And also in the Bible, then, there are so many times in that it says that with God, then, nothing is possible, nothing is hard to reach.
如果我想到这句还是不能做的话,
and with all these biblical verses, then, and yet I'm still not able to do so,
然后我又想起另一个信句就是说,
and I will keep bear in mind that another verse and the one that grant me strength and everything, I'll be able to do so.
如果还是不能做之后，我又更审测我的内心。
And if I'm still not able to do with all these biblical verses, then I will ask God then to let me examine my heart.
是因为我不肯做吗?
Is it because I'm not willing to do?
是因为你要我爱其他人，我说他们怎么值得我爱？
And or is it because you want me to love others, and yet are they worthy then of my love?
啊，他对我不好，我要报仇。
And because they ill-treated me, then I will take revenge.
然后我又会，如果这样子想的话，我就知道，这神说，深渊在我，我必报应。
But yet then, the Lord said, vengeance is mine then. I will take actions upon it.
如果我去报仇，就拿了神的功来做。
If I go ahead and do and take the revenge, then I'm actually taking the place of God.
然后这个远离了神，就代表我犯罪，我一定不开心的。
So if I do such thing, then I'm actually staying away from God, and this will displease Him.
啊，然后就说，如果神说你不可以散布谣言，哈，啊，但是我说我怎么可以做？他散布我的谣言，我要以牙还眼，以眼还眼。
And here then, if you go ahead and quick then to rush into anything and false witness then, and you probably will give the reason why then he did that. Of course, I have to do it then. I'm actually, a tooth for a tooth then. In other words, taking the revenge on my own hand. And that is not right. Because by doing so then, we ourselves then have fallen into sin.
所以立刻我说好了，神你说做就做了。So
we will right away and say, God, if you ask me to do, I will do.
你帮助我一定做到了。Because
with your help then, I will definitely be able to do it.
你可能发觉有这个概念的时候，你每一次就这样子走过，很难的都做到了。
So by the moment we kept in mind, we kept doing so, and it will become a simple act.
然后你就发觉你会变成一个最快乐的人。
You will also come to realize that you're actually obeying God, and it's a joyful thing. You become a joyful person.
然后我再给大家，再结束今天，我再送给大家，如果听神的话，神答应我们什么？
And lastly then, before I end my sermon then, if we obey God then, what is God's promise to us?
那我们不是为了求这个结果来爱神的，因为先求神的国跟神的义的话，现在主的话，这些就会给我们。
We're doing all this because what, not expecting to get anything from God, but holding on to God's word, seek ye first His kingdom and righteousness, and all these things will be added to you.
那我送给你们三个。
There are three verses.
诗篇128篇，第一节。
Psalm 128，第一节。凡敬畏耶和华、遵行他道的人，更为有福。Blessed are all who fear the Lord, who walk in His ways.
彼得前书2章6节。First
Peter.
2章6节的下半部。 信靠他的人必不至于羞愧。
For those who believe in him, he will not be put to shame.
第三个是箴言书1章33节。
And lastly then is Proverbs chapter 1 verse 33.
唯有听从我的必安然居住，乐享安静，不怕灾祸。
But whoever listens to me will live in safety and be at peace without fear of harm.
单单这三个应许应该够我们用。Just
these three biblical verses then to be sufficient for us.
因为人不可以将我们羞辱，羞辱不轻我们。Because
no one then will shame us.
而且我们不再怕灾祸，因为神说过，我是一个，我。 我能够将一切的咒诅变为祝福。
And also we will not be fear of harm then, because God says that He is able to turn all the curses to blessings.
就算我们现在还在水深火热之中,
even though right today then we are in the midst of all these troubles and hardships.
因为有着神的应许，我们就变成一个最有盼望的人。
And because of all these promises of God, then we are hopeful. 当每一个人、周围人都看到你是个最快乐的人，你是个最有盼望的人，他们一定会问你的为什么。And with the people surrounding you, upon seeing you, you are always joyful and hopeful that they will be so curious then to come and find out why.
我们就可以好像彼得前书3:15这样子告诉，用温柔的心准备好了，告诉人这个救恩。
And we will be like what Apostle Peter then taught us that when people ask us, we're able to use the gentleness and respect, be able to respond to others.
这样子我们就自动完成了神的大使命这个吩咐了。
And it will be so natural then that we will fulfill the great commission of God.
愿大家从今年开始，每一个人从自己开始跟神建立密切的关系。
And I just hope every one of us that, you know, at this time that build an intimate, close relationship with God.
求圣灵的帮助我们每一个。
May the Holy Spirit help every one of us.
大家同步的、彼此的、勉励的、共同的在灵里面成长。
And let us encourage each other, support each other then in this spiritual journey.
这种几何级数的增长就是教会成长的一个重要的一个部分。
And for us to be in unison, growing spiritually together, encouraging others, this is actually an important aspect of church growth.
愿主祝福大家。
May God bless every one of you.
感谢主。
Thank God.